إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن سار على نهجه وما استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد. And so, my brothers and sisters, here we are once again gathering, at least at the time of Jum'ah for most of us. And as always and forever, in all of our Jum'ahs that we have congregated in the past, we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send peace and blessings to His Rasul, salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi. And at this time, in this day and age, and during these difficult times, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us safe and to keep us healthy and allow us to reunite in His house, in our masajid and in our communities at a time that is pleasing to Him. Allahumma ameen. One of the things that I think at least it's been about a month that for most of us we've come to grips with our reality. We understand that things are going to be like this and things are going to remain this way for a while. And trying to convince each other that this is the new reality, the new normal, I think we've passed that point. And now it's a matter of remaining positive and trusting what is to come to at whatever capacity. I know for here today in Canada, today was the highest number of cases ever recorded, something like 460 or something cases of COVID-19 recorded today, which was the highest number so far. But then when you look at those numbers and you compare it to other parts of the world, like New York, in the States as a whole, Italy, Spain, all of these other countries, man, subhanAllah, they are really going through a tough time. So I want to also take a moment to pray for them, that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep them safe, bless them with His shifa and His cure, to them and to all of us, Allahumma ameen. This is not easy. And anybody who tries to brush this off and say to you, you know what, you should be looking forward to moments like this. If you ever express any kind of emotion that you're feeling sad or concerned or frightened, stay away from the people who say things to you like, what are you afraid of? You know, you're afraid to die? What's wrong with you? You're sad because of Allah's plan? You know, these kinds of narratives that are out there could be troublesome, especially for people who have low self-esteem, who have depression and anxiety, people who don't know how to cope with stress, especially when that kind of stress is beyond your control. And it's happening in areas and parts of your life where you have nothing to do with that. You don't know how to adjust that type of stress. You don't know how to stop it. And to tell somebody and to confront them and to say to them that, hey, look, you know, sorry about that, guys. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's plan, and you should just trust it, and you should just keep it this way, and you should just go on with your life and be happy and praise Allah. Really and truly, this is not from the sunnah. And as we mentioned in the past, remember that our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was scared himself. And there were times where he was so scared that he would immediately drop to in sujood and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask Him for nasr, ask Him for aid and help. And so it's really important that you separate that from the spiritual aspect of being afraid. Spiritually, we are encouraged to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be afraid of His punishment, to be afraid of consequences for disobeying Him. But then that natural part of us is We're human beings. We're always scared. Some of us are scared of bugs and bugs and other creatures like that, like scorpions and things like that. Other of us are just scared of animals, period. Others can be scared of one another. You're scared of crowds. You're scared of certain individuals, certain places, settings, and so on. It's okay. And so what I want to do is I want to take all of those emotions now and to turn it into something positive. Turn it into something that you and I, inshallah ta'ala, could use those kinds of feelings and emotions to help uplift ourselves, inspire ourselves, and to make us better people. And I want to bring your attention to a surah that I know most of you watching, you've memorized the surah. And you've known the surah since you were kids. And it is none other than Surah Al-Inshirah, which starts off, Alam nashrah laka sadrak. وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ, that surah. Now, I know when you hear that surah, we all know that surah. We mean we've known it forever. But that surah is one of the most important and powerful reminders of the entire Quran to help us stay optimistic and stay positive during difficult times. So go back now to the setting when that surah was revealed. Surah Al-Inshirah is actually one of the early surahs of Mecca. And that's important because just by setting alone, that it being one of the earliest surahs immediately tells you that this is one of the first things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching His ummah and especially His Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And so the question begs is, what would you say? What would you expect from Allah as one of your first statements or your first commands to the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam? What would you expect Allah azza wa jalla to say? For a lot of us, when we're feeling down, the first thing we say to one another is pray. You need to make dua. You need to go talk to somebody. You need to get out of this. You need to stop feeling this way. Like we attack the problem without really paying attention to the parameters that surround that problem. What are the influences? What are the things that are actually poking at the problem? So yeah, you might be attacking the actual issue itself. But what that does is that creates like a band-aid type solution. So you might get some relief, but you're still surrounded with so much fear, so much stress, that it's inevitable. It's just gonna happen again and again. This surah, listen to how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He tells him that in very early Mecca, when he was being persecuted, when the mushrikun were trying to assassinate him, they expelled him from Mecca, they tortured many of the companions, they threatened them, you name it. They took their land, they took their wealth, they took their money, everything was gone. And the Prophet ﷺ at this time is feeling really upset, really down. Today we might call that, he might have felt even a bit depressed of what was happening in Mecca. And just imagine yourself there for a minute. You're just trying to practice your religion. You don't want to idol worship. You don't want to worship anything except the true creator. You just want to practice your religion. And so the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam is feeling really down. He's feel like he's lost hope. And the first thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him, Alam nashrah laka sadrak? Didn't we open your chest? Inshirahu sadr, as we mentioned before, is the way the Quran keeps us calm. And so what Allah is saying is that, didn't I bless you? Alam nashrah laka sadrak? Didn't I bless you with forgiveness, with honor? Didn't we bless you with the message of the Quran? Didn't we bless you with guidance? So here's the first thing, guys, to get us through this, is remember, we have the greatest miracle we can imagine and think of, and that is the Quran. It's here. We still have access to that. We still can read that and study it and understand it and do our very best to try to implement it. So the fact that Allah still preserved the Quran is an indication that you have what it takes to be positive and to stay optimistic in His plan. One of the most effective ways and long-lasting ways to preserve and protect optimism and staying positive, not just in religion, but just in life in general, is to make the Quran a part of your day. Each and every single day, you're reciting some Quran. So for today, being the day of Jum'ah, if you haven't already recited Surah Al-Kahf, try to make some time and do that. And especially for those of you who don't know the surah, take some time each and every Friday or each and every day, whatever is easy for you, and start reading it. You'll notice that at the beginning of that surah, it might seem like one of the most difficult surahs to read. But just after a few times you do it, you'll end up comparing it to like Surah Al-Ikhlas and Surah Al-Fatiha. It becomes one of the easiest surahs to read and memorize. And so you start doing these little things, and that's how you start building this positive atmosphere. You start adding pieces, bits and pieces of positive puzzles, and you put all of that into create a complete picture. And so the first thing that Allah reminds His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam is like, didn't I give you that Quran already? You know, so didn't I keep you calm? I gave you some sense of reassurance, trust. Here's the plan. Why these things you think are happening to you? Well, here is why. Here is the wisdom. And you're not the first one. A third of the Quran is designated to generations and prophets and messengers of the past who had similar issues as well. So now with that being said, أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزَرَكَ الَّذِي أَنْقَضَ ظَهْرَكَ وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. So Allah continues, أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزَرَكَ. And we also lifted the burden that was resting on you. Wizrak is that also we lifted you from the burden of sin. We lifted you from the burden of stress that was weighing heavily on your shoulders. So وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ الَّذِي أَنْقَضَ ظَهَرَكَ. So we lifted from you this enormous weight. Now scholars of tafsir differ what that weight is. Some say the weight is sin. So the Prophet والسلام, Allah is saying to him, didn't I give you the greatest gift of forgiveness? And I lifted that burden off of you? Other scholars said no. Other scholars said it meant other things that Allah lifted from him. The pain and stress of worry, of contemplating and trying to figure out uncertainty, not knowing where this is going, not knowing why so many people are trying to persecute and hate on you and try to attack you. Like all of those little things that add to more pain and stress. Allah is saying, didn't we lift all of that from you? But here's the point. وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ الَّذِي أَنْقَضَ ظَهْرَكَ وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. Here's something for all of us, brothers and sisters. Allah Azza wa Jal says, and we gave you a legacy, ورفعنا, and we raised you that you were remembered more so than any previous prophet and messenger. In other words, how many times do we say sallallahu alayhi wasallam? How many times do we send peace and blessings to him sallallahu alayhi wasallam a day? And so even today being Jum'ah, the sunnah of Jum'ah is actually to constantly send more of peace and blessings to the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. You're trying to do that as much as you can. And some scholars say it's even more important on the day of Jum'ah to send peace and blessings to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam than it is to recite Quran on Jum'ah day. Now put this into perspective for a minute. In other words, today there is more barakah and blessing and reward for sending salam to the Prophet ﷺ as opposed to just sitting and reading Quran. It doesn't mean that the Quran is losing value. It doesn't mean that you're not showing importance to the book. It just means that everything has a certain time and place. And today being the day of Jum'ah, we constantly say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. So kathratu salam ala nabiy sallallahu alayhi wasallam. You're doing this as much as you can. And so Allah reminds him of that. So how does that translate to you and I? Guys, we're here. We get to live in our homes. We get to wake up. We get to appreciate each other. We get to still connect and talk to one another. We get to all of these blessings. We get to eat. We get to enjoy the company of our family. We get to spend time. We get to pretty much do everything that we want to and desire to do. But of course, some of the inconveniences that we're experiencing, as you know, we can't go outside. We can't go to places that we usually go to and so on and so forth. But inshallah, that time will come back. Those things will come back to normal. But right now, we just need to make sure that we keep our focus. And the way to build that focus is to keep yourself connected with the Quran. And number two, focus on all of the positive things that are still in you, that are still surrounding you, that you have in your life. I'm going to pause here, inshallah ta'ala. For those of you who are following, I just want to make this as close to a Jum'ah experience as possible. So I'm going to pause. pause here and take the jalsa or the resting period, and then when I stand up again, inshallah, we'll continue and conclude. Barakallahu li wa lakum fi al-Qur'an al-Karim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayati wa dhikr al-hakim. Aqulu ma tasma'un wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa risa'il al-muslimin min kulli dhanb fastaghfiruhu innahu huwa al-ghafuru rahim. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه أما بعد ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. To conclude, brothers and sisters, this is what I want to conclude with. It's all about just staying positive, staying strong. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Indeed, with every pain and struggle, there are multiple avenues of ease. Now listen to the way I'm translating this. Not after every pain and struggle. Okay, the ayah does not say, فَإِنَّ بَعْدَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. It says, مَعَ. مَعَ means with. So Allah is saying, with every one pain, there are multiple avenues of good or ease that are coming to that. So, فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Al-usr is the word that is used for hardship in this ayah. And usr is definitive. So those of you who study Arabic, you'll notice that al-usr is mentioned. So, إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. So usr has alif lam attached to it. In Arabic, we call this ma'rifa. So what that means is wherever the pain or the struggle or the stress is coming from, you're going to know what it is. You're going to know where it came from. It's not going to be impossible to figure out. And this, I thought, was just absolutely amazing and so reassuring for all of us. Every single pain that you are going through right now, whether it be the coronavirus or whether it be in your homes at a personal level, in your families, in your relationship, in your marriage, what have you, whatever struggle you're going through, Allah is saying in this ayah that you know where it's coming from. You could see it. He's not going to hide that. He's not going to, you know, hide that from you, that it's impossible for you to figure out your life and why it's going downhill, why all of these problems are coming. Allah is saying, I'm not going to, you know, keep that completely anonymous. You're going to know what it is. فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ. But then Allah says, but with that pain is yusra. Yusra is non-definitive. It's nakira. It doesn't have anything. It doesn't have an alif lam, which means Allah is going to send multiple avenues of ease, and you're not going to know where it comes from. You're not going to have a clue how it happened. And I think all of you listening to this, you all have a story like that, don't you? You all have a story of where you thought something was impossible, and somehow Allah just made it work. And one common example, you know, that just pops into my head all the time, it's like when you want to get married to somebody and all the pieces of the puzzles fit, everything was going fine, everything is smooth, but then some crazy problem happened, you think it's going to be all over, you already start saying your goodbyes to him or her, the marriage is done, and you think it's just a done deal. And all of a sudden, Allah makes it work. Somehow the marriage happens, or somehow Allah blesses you with somebody else. For those of you who come from the opposite, where if you've been divorced and you wonder, how are you going to ever marry again? How are you going to ever survive? You've got 3 or 4 kids, you're a single parent, and you've reached an age where society has created this taboo or the stigma against people at certain ages, they shouldn't get married again. And so all of this is just pounding on you and making you feel like it's hopeless for you to ever restart. And all of a sudden, Allah blesses you with the best spouse and you have a beautiful life and things become easy and you're just able to get through and wake up each and every day. So when you look at all of these things and when you take a moment to reflect about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had got you out of the worst situations that you yourself could not see any way out, Allah says, man, I sent so many avenues of ease to you. That's what I do. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does. That's what He wants you to focus on. So with this virus, today I watched the numbers globally. There is now officially over 1 million cases across this globe. And subhanAllah, just think about that number. Over 1 million people got sick with this virus, and it continues to spread like wildfire. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us and guarantees us, I'll get you through this. Don't worry. I need you to trust me and stay confident. Trust, I know what I'm doing. I'll get you all through this, bi-ithnillah. فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا Allah repeats it. So if you didn't get it the first time, you make sure you hear it the second time. He'll repeat it a second time for us. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ So when you finally get a moment to gather yourself, فَانْصَبْ No one really knows what the word فَانْصَبْ is talking about in this ayah. If you look up the tafsir of فَانْصَبْ, you'll see multiple opinions. And fansab, if you put it all together, fansab means to get up and get going again. Do something about your situation. So some scholars interpreted fansab to be make dua, make istighfar, start reading some Quran, start talking to Allah, get up, move, pray, go into sujood, lengthen the sujood, all of these things. So fansab means to get yourself moving. Start taking a step forward, even if it's just baby steps. Take one step forward and that will multiply. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ And guys, the one thing, the reason why we do all of this is وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ is because we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one that we desire. فَارْغَبْ from رَغْبَ رَغْبَ, we desire His pleasure, His forgiveness. We desire to be closer to Him than anything else. So if it's one thing that the coronavirus should have taught all of us by now, is that, and you've been seeing these reminders all across social media, is this is the time to get closer to Him. And this is the time that you should desire Him. This is the time that you should want to and feel closer to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what Surah Al-Inshirah is all about. And that is what Allah Azza wa Jal began to teach the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam very early in his prophethood. One of the first things he teaches his messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. And so with that being said, guys, I just want to make a dua for all of you listening and all of you out there. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you all safe. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you from the virus. And those of us, if we know somebody or one of us has received or gotten the virus, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you shifa. And every pain and struggle that you go through, may Allah remove the sins and pain and burden upon your shoulders, in your life. May Allah azza wa jalla use this time of struggle to remove all of that and purify our hearts and our lives. Allahumma ameen. And so with that being said, we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma aghfir al-muslimina wal-muslimat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive the Muslims across the world. May Allah azza wa jal protect them. Allahumma aghfir al-muslimina wal-muslimat wal-mu'minina wal-mu'minat al-ahya'i minhum wal-amwat innaka qareemun sami'un mujibu da'wat. Allahumma innana nas'aluka al-jannah. O Allah, we ask you for Jannah. Wa ma qarraba ilayha min qawlin aw amal. And allow us to do the things that bring us closer to Jannah in our actions and on our tongues. Allahumma innana na'udhu bika min adhab an-nar. We also ask you, O Allah, to protect us from the punishment of the fire. Wa ma qarraba ilayha min qawlin aw 'amal. And also allow us to stay away and protect us from the things that we do and the things that we say that could lead us towards that fire. O Allah, protect us. Allahumma ameen. And so with that being said, guys, I'll conclude. And just remember, it's time to pray your four raka'ats of Salatul Dhuhr if you haven't done so already. Jazakumullahu khairan, guys. Until we meet again, please stay safe wherever you are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.